Hey guys, it's Matthew again. Welcome back to another episode of Mixing. So in the last couple of episodes, we talked about, the first episode, we talked about setting up the mix session, organizing the layout, color coding, blah, 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 all that good stuff. In the second video, we talked about leveling, right? Getting the bits of your individual tracks a relatively consistent volume. And I'm not talking about from word to word, but I'm talking about from, you know, one chunk of the song to the next chunk, you know, from the verse to the chorus to the next verse, stuff like that. And so today, what I'm going to do is talk a little bit more about the controlling the dynamics of your song, okay, of the vocalists in particular. And there's going to be two parts. One is kind of a big picture, volume adjustments. The second part is going to be making use of compression. Okay. And everything we do here, nothing is finalized. It's just kind of, it's a bit of an iterative process. You get it started. You start off with your initial settings. You go back, you listen to it again, and you like it or you don't like it, you change it, and so forth. But anyways, the first thing that I've done, so I've got all my tracks here. Just to kind of narrow down the focus, I've got all the harmony tracks muted. So I'm going to hide those. And I've disabled all the plugins. So we're doing this initial kind of volume part without plugins. It's just manipulating the faders down here. And I've actually more or less already done this. Second of all, you'll notice if you look at the instrumental track, I've turned it down to -9, okay? And so this is specific to our situation where we're working with the official instrumental track, which is released, you know, with the CD or with the whatever. And those instrumentals, you know, that we get and we do covers for, by and large, they are pre-mastered, which means they are as loud as possible. What that means is if you just leave the fader at 0, right, the regular volume, it's going to be really loud. And whatever vocals you throw on, either they're going to be drowned out or you're going to have to turn them way up and then everything just starts clipping. So for these situations, I set the instrumental to start with at something like, at something like -9, okay? And that just gives us some more headroom, some more space to play with the volumes. And you know what? We can always boost it back up later. I've turned the instrumental track down, and I'm just going to play the song through, or at least chunks of it. And the idea is I'm looking at the bottom at the mixing dock, and I'm listening with my ears, and I'm trying to get these faders set up roughly so that they're about the right volume relative to each other. So, you know, the different vocal lines are similar in volume. The instrumental and the vocalist, they are roughly about, you know, matching up in volume. So here we go. Okay, I'm just going to stop it there. And so first thing, you know, one thing you'll notice if you look at the final mix, master, bus, whatever, we've already clipped. And I've turned the instrumental track down to -9. And, you know, the vocalist is not even that loud, right? It's actually kind of hard to hear what the vocalist is saying sometimes. Like sometimes the vocalist is loud, but other times it's very soft and you can't make out what they're saying. But there's a rough volume, but already I'm clipping. I'm going above 0 dB, right? And so this is why, you know, like, you got to turn the volume down when you're starting, you know, in our situation anyways. There's no reason to start off loud. Now, of course, I've already gotten a bit of a head start here. I'm going to reactivate all my plugins. You know, the solution to the vocal tracks being mostly loud enough, but then some parts not, you know, some words being kind of too soft is compression. And compression basically makes it so that the loud parts are not as loud and the quiet parts are not as quiet. That's the end result we're going for. We're aiming for, within a phrase, for a more consistent volume so that every word can be heard. That's different from what we did the last time, where we were taking big chunks of sections of songs and leveling the volumes. That was to give us a consistent track to mix with. But right now, we're going nitty-gritty into the individual phrases and trying to get every part of the phrase to be heard properly. And so at this point, you pick whatever compressor you want, whichever one you're used to using. But when I mix with my compressors, right, and I'll take my first vocalist's lines here. So this is Haley. You know, I almost always use the default compressor to start with. That's the recomp, right? And I've had pretty decent luck with one of the presets is the modern vocal, right? And I'll walk you through what I try to do. So I'm going to activate it. And I'm just going to get the song going, right? Hold on. So modern vocal, that's the preset. Okay, there we go. So what I'm looking at is this little bar here. You notice the red kind of dips up and down. That's your gain reduction meter. I'm going to go to a different section. This is the next solo for Haley. Singing deep into the depths of my heart. So when she sings heart, you notice that it dips down to -3. So basically, that's just taking the loudest part of this line, that's heart, and turning it down a little bit so it's not as loud. Okay. We can keep going. Okay. So actually, if you take a look at these two solos that we just went through, right, and we look at what the compressor was doing, and of course that's the gain reduction. At one point it did a -3, and then at maybe 2 points it did a -1 or a -2, which basically is it did nothing. Kind of my aim that I want to see the gain reduction hitting around -3, right, when it gets loud. And the way to do that is basically to just bring down the threshold, this thing here. And it takes a bit of experimenting. You know, the default was -21 something. If you notice that your compressor is not doing anything or doing very little, you bring the threshold down. So let's see it again. So already you see that for that first couple of words, it's actually doing a bit more, right? Let's go to the next. Oh, got a message there. Let's go to the next solo. And so you can keep bringing it down. Okay, now you can really see it's doing stuff. And so It depends a lot on the genre of music, right? And then it also depends on the particular singer. But most of the time, what I try to go for is a gain reduction of between -3 and -6 decibels. So back there, I was getting like closer to -7. So that's too much compression. I'm going to bring the threshold back up a little bit and just see what we get. And so before we're saying how even with everything turned down, once the vocal instrumental and the singer was put together, the meter was clipping, you know, the master bus, the final output was going above 0 dBs, and that was bad. Now I've kind of turned down the maximum volumes on Haley's main lines. I can actually boost the volume. So for example, I can take this knob here. This is the wet knob. That's just another way of saying the output of this plugin. Or I can go down here. I can boost up the fader, right? But let me show you what happens if I just boost up by 3 decibels now. Okay, so now you notice it's much easier to hear a lot of the individual words. I'm going to turn this off and you can compare. Right, with this off, looking up, the light is green. It's hard to make out looking up. But with this turned back on, it's a bit easier to make it out. Now, I was saying before how, you know, a lot of this depends on your particular vocalist. Some vocalists have very wide dynamic range, very soft, very loud. And you know, for those vocalists, it takes a bit more work to kind of get the performance evened out so that you can hear every single word. And you can go back again with automation to bring out individual words. Because we have compressors, which do a lot of the heavy lifting for us, I try to make as much use of them as I can. The only downside is sometimes when you use a compressor like this, you get some kind of unmusical artifacts. It just sounds unnatural because the volume is shifting back and forth in real time. So, one thing you can do is, you know, let's say we didn't like how this sounded. There was too much unnatural artifacts. What we can do is, you know, instead of having the compression work so aggressively, we can dial it back a little bit. So it's still working, but it's not working, you know, all the way to -6. And then I can take another compressor after that. So you have two compressors back to back. Oftentimes you can get a sound that is a bit more natural, a bit more musical sounding. And so one compressor I've been using recently is this one, CLA-2A from Waves. It's relatively inexpensive. It's only $29 when it's on sale. And I like it because it's really easy to use. Basically, this is kind of the default setting. I turn it on, and for me, most of the time, I just take this knob and dial it up and down. Okay, so here goes. And you'll notice, actually, that the first thing you'll notice is it's already much louder. So by default, this plugin does turn up the volume, because it assumes that you're going to turn down the volume with the compressor. So it's going to be louder, just to warn you. Sinking deep into the depths of my heart, where is the sun I seek? Looking up, the light is green, now I know. Okay, that's probably too loud. So I'm going to turn, so the left-hand knob is the gain. I'm going to turn it back down a little bit, just so it's similar to the previous volume. Okay, so that's about what the volume was before. So I'm going to play it, and I'm going to twist this knob up and down, and this line represents the gain reduction. And again, I'm going to go for, this time, about -3.
Looking up, the light is green, now I know. Here I grew, a new horizon, uncharted land, lay bare before us, so fine.
So now I've got two compressors back to back, each one doing, you know, around -3 decibels of gain reduction. All that's happened right now is I've turned down the volume, right? So in order to make up for that, I'm going to turn up the volume to bring everything back to the volume I want it at. Deep into the depths of my heart, where is the sun I see? Looking up, the light is green, now I know. Tearing through a new horizon, uncharted lands lay bare before us. So fly, take a chance, and you will soar. Take my hand and we'll go. Okay, that's more like it. So not only is the entire thing seems louder, but I'm not clipping, right? If you look at the master readout, it's not going above zero, whereas before, if I had it this loud, it would have. But also the individual words, for the most part, are much easier to make out. There's probably still some more fine-tuning, and so later on, I will go back and do more automation to bring out, you know, whatever the compressor wasn't able to fix. I'll go back and fix it manually. But you can see with, you know, these two plugins, I've been able to do kind of a lot of the work. So I'm going to do this for all of the main vocal lines. Another thing I want to show you is, you know, there are other parts of the song. You know, there are these kind of backing vocals, these kind of bracketed vocals. Before me, hey you, you saw my dream too. And then with the harmonies, it's before me, hey you, you saw my dream too. Hey you, you saw my dream too, right? And so for these parts where they're not really the main focal point of the song, they're kind of there as an accent, as a support. There are a couple of things that I like to do, and one of them is to hit the compression really hard. And so for example, these kind of bracketed supporting lines. If I pull up Haley's lines here, here's the first compressor. Me, hey you, you saw my dream too. Diving. All right, and then here's the next one. This is another compressor I like to use. So this window here is the gain reduction. Me, hey you, you saw my dream too. Diving. So, you know, both of these compressors were hitting around -4 decibels, right? So it's a bit more aggressive. And that's because I don't want there to be big swings in volumes for these supporting parts. I want it to be very even, because if these kind of background supporting parts kind of jump around in volumes, they will grab the attention away from the main soloist. Same thing with the harmonies. In harmonies, I'm even more aggressive. So what I've got in here is, for example, I've got Hikari's harmony lines. I've got all three of my compressors activated, and they're all doing a couple of decibels of gain reduction. And that really makes it so that there are very few peaks in loudness. It's very even. It doesn't stand out. It's there, but it doesn't stand out. Later on, what you can actually do is you notice all of these harmonies, right? They're all put into this one folder, and I apologize, I'm getting some messages here, but I've got them all in this one folder. I can actually put another compressor on this one and squash the sound even more so that it's even more even. So, you know, there's no one-size-fits-all kind of setting for compression. It's different for the genre of music. It's different for the singer. It's different for the section of the song, the role of that line. And I'm not going to pretend I know all of it, but these are kind of the differences that I would apply to my mixes. And maybe, I am sorry. And maybe you have different ideas, and you know, you can feel free to share them, how you would approach that. But yeah, that's kind of my approach to, one, setting out the faders kind of in a rough way so that things are relatively even, relatively close to where I want them to be, and then adding compression after the fact to even out the phrasing within each line. If this was informative, I'll leave a comment. Next time we'll talk about timing. And yeah, until next time, take care. All the best. Bye-bye.